worth 6 months getting wired junk to spin this whole thing. Doesn't it seem strong to you, Peter? Doesn't it?
As long as the bloody bed covers don't fray. That's all I'm worrying about. Nearly there.
Piece of cake.
You beauty.
Ah! I write to you, and you don't write to me.
Hello.
No. What's your little name? You come here often? Oh, you're so cute. Give us a kiss.
I love you, Screw.
Don't shoot me. I'm very new at this.
I'm not going to shoot you.
It's too hot.
You're under the gate and we'll get on great.
Come on, move it.
Mate, Pete, we're gonna Brazil!
It will be the 11th execution at Pentridge. Ryan will be executed from the same beam as used in the execution of Ned Kelly at the old Melbourne jail.
But I hesitated and I took home a second time and I discharged the rifle.
Ronald Ryan claimed he did not fire the shot which killed George Hudson.
At 40 seconds to 8 o'clock on the 3rd of February 1967, Ryan's body shot down behind the screen out of sight.
I've never believed the stories in the press. The stories on television all seemed like social fiction to me. And I was looking for him for a long time. The real Ryan, you know, the earthly Ryan, not the mythical one. Ryan was interesting and stupid and kind and selfish. An appalling bungler and an imitation burglar. I think he's every man, that Ryan is every man full of faults, brim full of faults and full of treasure. So I don't sanctify him, but I say that Ryan lived, and the stage gives him that reincarnation.
Stretch out your arms, Ryan, and turn around. Do your famous impression of Christ again. Not a mark on him, is there?
No, sir.
Speak up.
Not a mark or a bruise, sir.
And that's the way he's going to stay.
Everybody has a different story about Ronald Ryan. Some people said he was a mad dog. Some people said he was just a family man. Other people say he was, you know, he's next to being a saint. A misunderstood saint. You know, some people say he's completely innocent. Some people said he did it. I have to play Barry's interpretation, Barry's story. If I start playing someone else's interpretation of who he was, if I was to play Henry Bolte's idea of who Ronald Ryan was, it's a very, very different man from who Barry thinks he is and who perhaps Father Brosnan thinks he is, who Dorothy thinks he is.
And how are your chums at Olympic time?
For black men, they are white men.
And what exactly do you do with your Olympic wheels?
I'm a moulder.
I beg your pardon?
I mould?
You're a moulder.
I mould the shapes. Ever heard of recaps?
Recaps, Mother?
Well, I assumed that was a dental term.
He was comic, and the only way to show that he was comic is through anecdotes, because there are no jokes in the police histories. The jokes come from workmen, his sisters, his wife. His wife, Dorothy, is as amusing as he was.
What do you think of the ruling class?
No, I don't. Only you. You're the first aristocrat I've ever met.
They're not bad people. Dad makes decent hearses.
Oh, I'm sure he does.
He likes you.
I'll live with him then.
The man had an extraordinary wit. The man had an extraordinary sense of style and class. I mean, a man who can, kiss his daughters goodnight and then a couple of hours later be tiptoeing through a warehouse, steal, 300 suits, but forget the trousers. There's something quite joyful there. There's something really, there's something really beautiful there. I mean, the man got away with nothing. You know, he didn't get away with anything in his life.
I've got great luck, haven't I? God Almighty must have been in an ironic mood when I was born.
Stop down, crook! Right on the face.
From both of you, though. It's just merely don't laugh before it.
Oh, it says to laugh. Oh, I always follow the script.
And to come to rehearsal physicalises it. It's no longer cerebral. It's great to see the actors' toes and their ankles and their feet and the hint of makeup, you know. Coming to rehearsal has been the redemption. I mean, I felt as if I've been in hell for 3 years.
Who do you love?
The Lord Jesus Christ.
Do you love him more than your own father?
No.
Yes! Who do you love?
Oh, my mother and father I love, my brothers and sisters, and anyone else who's around.
Do you realise how lucky you are to be a guest at this boy's own room?
I've got a pretty good idea.
Ah, the Lord Jesus might laugh at you, Ronald. He must really slap his thighs and laugh at you.
I don't mind if he laughs at me. I like the sound of his laughing voice, as a matter of fact. I love his laughter.
I thought there was a great injustice done to the Christian Brothers. In the play, they had him with Christian Brothers belting him. And I think this is very unfortunate, but that's the only complaint I would have. But I think it has to be corrected. He was not a long product of boys' homes. He was only there for a short time and a happy time, so I'm glad to have the opportunity of pointing that out.
Just come to Mass, there's nothing to fill in.
That's how I feel, like I've got a hole inside me.
Have my Bible. Keep it. You know it, read it again.
What's that piece of newspaper you've got marking your place?
Race results at Caulfield, last night's Herald.
Apparently there's a horse called Son of Man, running tomorrow. Could you put a unit each way on for me, Father?
Son of Man.
See, he looked out the gallows, out the door of the condemned cell about 20 minutes before he was to die. I don't know, he said, it's very hard to know which is better, that, looking at the gallows, or 30 years in this loveless environment.
The Catholics idolise him because he didn't squib it. He died with aplomb. He died without a qualm. He died with a wink. And he winked at Brian Morley from 3AW. And that wink hasn't been forgotten by Brian Morley.
The result is that in law the case was of constructive murder by Ryan. The jury directed that the Crown must prove that Ryan killed Hodson and that killing amounted to murder. For these reasons, we are of the opinion the appeal cannot succeed.
I was dead in a second and it all went rather well. I never lived, I never had a name, I never had daughters. The worst thing the state can do is take your history from you. A cloud of lime and Bob's your uncle, even if he isn't. As far as I'm concerned, there is nothing as violent as an execution. People amaze me when they say, why bother about a little crim like Ryan? I say, if you don't bother about Ryan, who do you bother about? I've been only on about one topic, really. That one topic is justice. And there never has been justice for Ronald Ryan.
The Kennett government still won't have a headstone for Ryan. There's no history. Until he gets a headstone, born in Mitcham in 1925, murdered in 1967. He lived for nearly 42 years. He used to get his hair cut in Sydney Road, Coburg. He lived and he walked and he had these daughters whom he loved and a wife whom he loved and so on. Until there's a marker, then he has no history. So the play gives him a history.
In the end, a man that can say, God bless you, to the person who's about to kill you, the person who puts a noose around your neck and is about to pull the lever, the person that say, God bless you, and mean it, is an admirable human being.